And I remember she kept saying, why don't you use Tarara Boomdie? I like that song. We said, well, we like it too, but it's an original musical, Mrs. Travers. And then she said, why don't you use Green Sleeves? I love Green Sleeves. Mrs. Travers, we love Green Sleeves too, but it's not an original song for the film. Later on, we did use a little flavor of that. Well, here we are at the racetrack. And actually, the racetrack was where we did the Pearly song, which was actually Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Pearlies are the musicians that play at these wonderful sporting events. They're all dressed up in pearl buttons sewn onto their costumes in beautiful decorative designs. And it's a great English tradition. But at any rate, producing that song was quite a bit of a chore. To get a professional to sound like an amateur is very, very difficult. Now, here's something you haven't heard before. This is the individual instruments playing as the Pearly Band. We had to record each instrument separately and then put them all together. And you do that with very precise timing. It's called a click track, which is the rhythm track, which is put in earphones for the musicians to hear. You hear that click and you play your music into that rhythm. Even the voices were separated.
It's supercalifragilisticexpialidocious, even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious.
We had Julie singing, and we had Dick singing, and then we had the umdiddlers in the background, them singing also. So we had quite a bit of separation to make this simple little song.
Oh, supercalifragilisticexpialidocious, even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious. Say it loud enough, you'll always sound precocious. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
We call this song the Pearly Song.